Hello all, we are here to solve previous year 8 questions. So this question is from manufacturing. The same question says, two mined steel plates of similar thickness in butt joint configuration are welded by gas tungsten arc welding process using the following welding parameters. Welding voltage is given as 20 volt, welding current is 150 ampere, welding speed is 5 mm per second. A filler wire of the same mild steel material having 3 mm diameter is used in this welding process. The filler wire feed rate is selected such that the final weld bead is composed of 60% volume of feeder and 40% volume of plate material. The heat required to melt the mild steel material is 10 joules per mm cube, and heat transfer factor is 0.7 and melting factor is 0.6. The heat rate of the filler wire is. So we need to find the heat rate of filler wire. Now, before finding this heat rate of the filler wire, first we have to have idea about the area of the weld bead, right? And in order to have idea about the area of the weld bead, we will proceed. As you can see in this human figure, this is mild steel plates are there, and this filler material is there, which is also of the mild steel, right? So if we see on the human data, so how we can proceed in, right? We can use this melting factor. Let us see this melting factor. This efficiency. Right. So actually, heat required or the energy required for this melting is, let us say, HM, okay. And let us say heat is supplied, which means we know, right, because this particular melting factor is 0.6 maybe. It means whatever heat is there or required for melting, it needs to be provided in excess, because it is not having full efficiency, right? Because maybe this 0.6 melting factor is in the 0.6. So HM by HS is given by this 0.6. Now HM is directly given by this melting heat required for melting of mild steel is 10 joules per meter mm cube, right? So here, if you consider heat supply, then heat supply is actually, it should be again in joule per mm cube, right? So heat supply will be again in joule per mm cube. Let us see this power, right? This is Vi, that is in cube, right? So here, if we write like this area into velocity, right? So, if we write like that, then welding speed will be used by per second. If we write this area into this velocity, then it will be unit per second. Okay, then here power is also joule per second. So, if we check the unit in this kind of numericals, so here it is joule per second, here it is unit per second. So it will be again joule per mm cube, because our actual is given as 7 joule per mm cube. So once you have this, but here when you are calculating this heat supply, the one thing you need to consider is this heat transfer thing. Right. So we need to multiply this with this heat transfer rate, right? Because it is not again 100%, it will be 70%. So you have all this data here, this voltage and this current, and his philosophy, right? As well as he. So here, if we use all this given data, then we will be able to get the area of the field. Let us see the area of the field. So here, now from this given data, if you want to calculate the area of the field, then you can put the given value 0.6 is equal to HM is given as 10. And V is given as, let us see what is this V. Z is 20. I is given as 150. Because HS is V, I can E, right? So E, and then this V is given as 5 meters of V. Then this is given as 0.7, right? This heat transfer vector. Now, once you solve this for area, then it will be the same as this and the 16 into 0.7 19 is 6 into 7 is 52. So this will be 52 by 8, so A will be 2 in the numerator, so 52 will be multiplied by this 0.6, I guess. This 52 will be multiplied by 0.6, and then 22 is 25.2 square. So once you get this area of the next thing, you need to calculate the period of the inner wire. So in order to find that you need a volume of its metal and electrode volume of metal from electrode and neutron is given by volume of metal and neutron volume of spinner neutron in this one. Right, so as you know, this volume of metal from electrode per electron is the volume of spinner neutron in the joint per unit time. So this first one is given by this area of electrode and the field rate of electrode. Right, it will be equal to the area of weld bay will be the bending speed into the amount of this filler metal in the this particular this weld bay, right? That is 0.6, right? Because 60% is of this filler material is given in the problems that you need to see that. Right, this 60% volume of filler is given, right? So that is why this A will be 0.6 is mentioned. Now AE is this pi by 2 into the diameter of the wire, filler wire, that is PM. So pi by 4 square into this PA is equal to this volume. So this area in pi by 2 into this value speed is 5%. So now if you are able to solve this, then it will come around. It's 10.71 mm per second. So this is the answer. Yes. Thank you.